So good morning. So he's Mr. Rahul Bhatt. He was a student. So he did his history optional with us in 2015. So if I'm not wrong, he joined us on December 18th, 2015, and he joined our GAs in 2016. So he was with us for a long term. It's been a long journey. So now he's secured rank 68, and history was his optional, and so he was our student. So now Rahul will introduce himself, and he'll just tell you like how history as a optional like helped him to score more. And he just cleared his prelims in the first attempt, and he wrote his mains. He got very good marks in history, and in the second attempt he succeeded and got rank 68. So now Rahul will introduce and take the lead. Thank you.
I would start with history optional. What are the book list and material which I read, which I studied, and which I would advise you people also to study and not to go beyond it. You see, limiting your sources is very important in this journey. You have to limit your sources, and you will have to have maximum optimization out of that. So if you could even write it, it would be fine. Don't go beyond this. The book list is condensed, easy, and sure shot to write very good answers in mains. Don't go beyond this. Agar isse beyond gaye to mushkil ho jayega. You need to are you fresh batch? When have you joined? June. Quite fresh. So I would ask you to start with NCRTs, 11th and 12th. Usse pehle wali nahi, 11th and 12th ki NCRTs. You see, now there are two sets of NCRTs, in fact three sets of NCRTs which can be read. One is Tamil Nadu NCRTs. Second is Ancient India, Medieval India and Modern India by R.S. Sharma, Satish Chandra and Bipin Chandra respectively. And the third one is themes, 1, 2, 3. But I would advise you, I would ask you to study and go for Tamil Nadu NCRTs preferably. If you find them boring, if you find them a little dry, go for R.S. Sharma, Satish Chandra and Bipin Chandra. If you find them even dry, if you find even them dry, go for themes. कुछ एक सेट पढ़ लेना पर जरूरी से, सारे सेट मत पढ़ने लग जाना, कुछ नहीं पढ़ाई होगी फिर, ठीक है? कोई एक सेट अच्छी तरह पढ़ लेना, preferably तमिलनाडु की NCRTs, ओके? Ancient, medieval and modern, it would help you in prelims as well as in mains. When you start, when you finish reading NCRTs of 11th and 12th, और ये जो बुक लिस्ट बता रहा हूँ, ये आज ही जाके खरीद के घर पे रख लेना. क्योंकि आपको एक आइडिया मिल जाएगा, इससे बाहर कुछ नहीं करना, जो है यही है. जब आप NCRTs खत्म कर लेंगे तो आई वुड एडवाइस यू हाउ टू अप्रोच NCRTs. डोंट स्ट्रेस योरसेल्फ टू मच आफ्टर पॉलिटिकल हिस्ट्री. डोंट रीड टू मच अबाउट कि शाहजहां का बेटा कौन था और औरंगजेब के कितने बेटे थे एटसेट्रा. डोंट गो अराउंड दीज थिंग्स, ओके? कौन किस बैटल में मरा, कौन किस, नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट एट ऑल. What is more important is social history, economic history, cultural history, religious history, okay? These are important aspects of history which you need to know. Analysis of history, events, events to sabko pata honge ke, okay? What have you read recently? What have you read of late? R.S. Sharma you have read? Okay, okay, fine, fine. So you see, events are like Ashoka died and then Brihadrath came and then successive rulers came, vagara, Ashoka, Mauryan Empire. But you see, what is the analysis of this, of these events? The decline of Mauryan dynasty, a decline of Buddhism. This is how you have to analyze an event, okay? No strong rule, decline of centralized rule. This is the qualitative appropriation to the event that happened in history. Okay, you don't need to memorize event, rather you need to analyze that event. Do you understand what I am saying?
Yes.
So read history in that manner. Okay. After you finish reading history, start RS Sharma ancient ke liye kafi hai, advanced study ke liye bhi. No more advanced study for ancient India much. Rather, I would say go for medieval India, J.L. Mehta. Ma'am would have told you. J.L. Mehta achhi tarah padhiye, medieval India. Same, I would say don't go or stress yourself after political history. Don't go kaun sa raja kab aaya, kiske baad kaun sa death hua. Don't go too deep or stress out yourself after dates. Just have a chronological sequence in your mind. Okay? Medieval India ke liye J.L. Mehta is important. And then for modern India, there are two books which can be read, either of the two books. I would not say go for both of them. I would say either of the two books. One would be Bipin Chandra, which I read, India's Struggle for Independence, jo 500-530 pages ki hai, blue color ki ya jispi color ki. India's Struggle for Freedom, or go with Shekhar Bandopadhyay, Plassey to Partition. I would personally suggest you to go for Shekhar Bandopadhyay. I haven't read it completely, but I have gone through few chapters and I find it more suitable for UPSC mains exam. Bipin Chandra is a very engaging read. It's a very good read. It's like a movie. It's like a flow. You get engaged and you get a flow of events in your mind, etc. But if you want to prepare in accordance with what UPSC demands or what the nature of questions, how the nature of questions come in UPSC, then Shekhar Bandopadhyay is much preferable. Okay? But if you find Shekhar Bandopadhyay to be dry, which it is to some extent, then you can probably go for Bipin Chandra to have an engaging read. Okay? Bipin Chandra is surely an engaging read. And you will get an overview of modern India, modern history. And then is world history. World history, in world history, first start with a book called Jain and Mathur. Ma'am might have told you, I suppose. Jain Mathur, and read it till 1848 July Revolution. Don't read it completely. It's a very thick book. Don't read it completely. Start with Renaissance. And then go with American Revolution, French Revolution, and other chapters like German Unification, Italian Unification. And then end it with July 1848 Revolution, which happened in France and Europe. Okay? And after you finish July 1848 Revolution, go for another book of world history, which is Norman Love, A Brief History of World. वो स्टार्टिंग होती है फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर से. इट स्टार्ट्स विद वर्ल्ड वॉर वन. सो रीड इट टिल 370 पेजेस, 370 टू 400 पेजेस. इफ एनीबडी हैज दैट बुक राइट नाउ, आई कैन इवन टेल यू. ओके, रीड टिल 370 टू 400 पेजेस, प्रोबेबली टिल जापानीज एंड स्पैनिश फासिज्म. नॉट आफ्टर दैट. आफ्टर दैट अमेरिकन इंपीरियलिज्म आ जाएगा, और ग्लोबलाइजेशन और पॉपुलेशन एंड वर्ल्ड हंगर प्रॉब्लम आ जाएगी. दैट्स नॉट मच इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर वर्ल्ड हिस्ट्री. ओके, सो नॉर्मल लव फर्स्ट 370 टू 400 पेजेस वुड बी इनफ. एंड आई वुड ऑल्सो आस्क यू टू रीड राउज आईएएस स्टडी मटेरियल. आपने जब हिस्ट्री ऑप्शनल ज्वाइन किया होगा तो आपको 5 किताबों का सेट मिला होगा, 5 blue books, history optional ka. I tell you, after reading all these books, you will not be able to write any answer in mains. You will be shocked. When you will read all these books, you will, ab aap mains ke question paper nikalenge aur try karenge solve karna, aapko aayega hi nahi likhna. Kyunki these all are reference books, not designed in accordance with what UPSC demands. So I would ask you first to download syllabus and take its print out, read it thoroughly. What are the topics in the syllabus? Okay, there are 27 topics roughly, I suppose. And after that, if you will see Rao's IAS study material, 5 blue books, then you would notice how beautifully they have been written. In accordance with what the syllabus demands. जैसे पहला टॉपिक है sources, UPSC के syllabus में. अब कोई सा भी टॉपिक पढ़ लो, अब कोई सा भी रेफरेंस बुक पढ़ लो, कहीं पे sources एक जगह तो नहीं है. मगर ब्लू बुक में sources 8 to 10 पेज हैं, एक जगह है. अगर आपने उसको पढ़ लिया, you would be able to write any answer on sources. Okay, so Rao's blue books, 5 blue books are noteworthy. They should be read. I read them in my first attempt and they were very beneficial to write answers in mains. They are written jaise syllabus ke topics hai na, usi unhi topics ko achhi tarah cover kar diya hai blue books mein, condensed approach mein. Ek topic hai art and culture during Mughal times. अब किसी रेफरेंस बुक में ये स्ट्रेट फोर्थ चैप्टर नहीं है, मगर इस इन ब्लू बुक्स में स्ट्रेट फोर्थ ये चैप्टर है एक, मुगल आर्ट एंड कल्चर. ओके, सो आफ्टर रीडिंग दीज रेफरेंस बुक्स आइदर साइड बाय साइड और वंस यू फिनिश दीज रेफरेंस बुक्स, गो कंप्लीटली फॉर राउज आईएएस का स्टडी मटीरियल, 5 बुक्स. इट विल हेल्प यू, टेक माई वर्ड्स. ओके, इट विल हेल्प यू राइट ब्यूटिफुल आंसर्स इन मेन्स, mature answers in mains. So after you finish these things, then you have a map. Map is a very interesting portion which I would suggest don't ignore, but don't stress out yourself too much also after map. Okay, ki map badi zaruri karna hai. I did not do map bada seriously, but I would suggest ki aap kar le seriously thoda sa day one se hi thoda thoda साथ साथ कर लीजिएगा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अगर आप इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन पढ़ रहे हैं और उसमें आपको मैम पढ़ा रही हैं चानहुदारो, आमरी, कोडदिजी, मांडा, लोथल, धोलावीरा, हाँ, कालीबंगन, आलमगीरपुर, सुक्ता जिंडौर एट्सेट्रा, अगर आपको वो पढ़ा रही हैं तो आप साथ साथ अपने दिमाग में भी रखिए ये सब कहाँ कहाँ है. ठीक है, तो इसके लिए अगर आप साथ साथ कर रहे हैं मैप, तो एनसेम्बल मैं आपको कहूँगा, एक किताब है मैप की, मैम ने आपको शायद कहा ही होगा, मैम तो बुक लिस्ट दे ही देती हैं पहले दिन ही, पहले या दूसरे दिन. एनसेम्बल की किताब पढ़ लीजिए, और स्पेक्ट्रम की एक बुक आती है मैप की, वो पढ़ लीजिए. स्पेक्ट्रम थोड़ी छोटी किताब है, पतली है, तो इसलिए कहा हूँ, मेरे जैसों के लिए बड़ी ज़रूरी थी स्पेक्ट्रम, क्योंकि मैंने मैप पूरे साल भर नहीं किया, मुझे 1-1.5 महीने के अंदर अंदर करना था क्योंकि मेंस देना था. तो मैंने स्पेक्ट्रम लाई, वो सिर्फ 150 पेजेस की किताब है. ऑन द अदर हैंड एनसेम्बल इज 300-310 पेजेस, तो मेरे लिए इतना टाइम नहीं था, तो मुझे जल्दी करना था, तो आई हैड टू डू स्पेक्ट्रम. और उसमें मोर और लेस वो साइट्स कवर्ड हैं जो UPSC में पिछले 20-25 साल में कवर्ड हो चुकी हैं, तो उस तरह से किया मैंने, पास्ट ईयर पेपर्स उठा के देख लिया. इसलिए मैप में आई वुड हैव कॉस्ट ऑल्सो इन मैप. मैप में मैं सिर्फ 25 नंबर का कर पाया मैप, उसमें भी शायद 13-14 मार्क्स आए होंगे. तो अगर मैंने 50 नंबर का किया होता तो माई रैंक वुड हैव बीन इवन फर्दर अप, मे बी 30 or 20. कोई मैटर नहीं हुआ वैसे, इट डजंट मैटर मच वैसे. ठीक है, सो एनसेम्बल कर लीजिएगा, आई वुड सजेस्ट डे वन से अगर आप कर रहे हैं. मगर मैं क्योंकि समझता हूँ आप सब स्टूडेंट्स हैं मेरी तरह ही पहले, जैसे मैं था, तो अगर कोई निक ऑफ टाइम में जिसको करना हो तो स्पेक्ट्रम भी अच्छी किताब है, जिसको टाइम ना मिले पूरे साल भर करने का. बिकॉज दिस कोर्स इज टू मच, यू हैव टू डू अदर थिंग्स ऑल्सो, यू हैव टू डू GS ऑल्सो, यू हैव टू डू हिस्ट्री में NCERTs, GL मेहता, बिपिन चंद्रा और शेखर बंदोपाध्याय, जैन एंड माथुर, नॉर्मन लव, राउज का IAS स्टडी मटीरियल. आफ्टर डूइंग दिस मैप के लिए कहाँ टाइम बचता है. बट एक अच्छा आइडिया या प्रपोजल ये है कि जब मैप पढ़ाती हूँ इंडस वैली सिविलाइजेशन, या मैम महाचनपदास पढ़ाती हूँ, बुद्धिस्ट साइट कोई पढ़ाती हूँ, कुंडल वन और एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशंस पढ़ाते हूँ, विक्रमशिला, नालंदा, वल्लभी, ओके, कांचीपुरम, तो आप साइट आप दिमाग में भी रख लीजिएगा कि ये कहाँ पे है साइट. मदुरई, चोला एम्पायर, बृहदीश्वरा टेम्पल, ओके, तो आप दिमाग में भी रख लीजिएगा या उसी दिन देख लीजिएगा मैप में कि ये साइट है कहाँ पे. डोंट स्ट्रेस आउट योर सेल्फ कि हाँ अब मैं यहीं पे रटूंगा, ये साइट यहीं पे है, बट जस्ट हैव एन आइडिया कि ये साइट यहाँ पे है, ओके फाइन, आपको एक आइडिया लग जाएगा, ठीक है। तो उस तरह से मैप कीजिए डे वन से, ऐसे मत कीजिएगा कि एनसेम्बल लाई और पहली साइट जो लिखी है वो अब प्लॉट करता हूँ, दूसरी साइट जो लिखी है वो प्लॉट करता हूँ। जैसे जैसे आपका सिलेबस बढ़ता जाता है, एंशियंट का ही मैप आता है, मिडीवल का मैप नहीं आता है, सिर्फ एंशियंट हिस्ट्री की ही मैप साइट्स होती हैं। तो आप साइड बाय साइड जैसे आप पढ़ रहे हैं आर एस शर्मा या राउल्स की आई एस स्टडी मटेरियल या मैम के नोट्स, तो आप मैप की साइट्स भी अलॉन्ग साइड मैप प्लॉट कर दीजिए। बार बार एम्फेसाइज कर रहा हूँ ये चीज़, ठीक है। जब आप ये सब कुछ कर लीजिएगा, जब आप ये किताबें बेसिक मिनिमम पढ़ लीजिए, उसके बाद आप डायरेक्टली मेंस लिखने मत चले जाना। इसके बाद आप पास्ट ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर्स क्रॉनिकल आईएएस, ये बहुत कम लोगों को पता है, नहीं करते हैं पास्ट ईयर के क्वेश्चन पेपर्स प्रैक्टिस। क्रॉनिकल की आईएएस की किताब आती है, मार्केट में शायद अवेलेबल नहीं है, ऑनलाइन अवेलेबल है, ऑनलाइन ऑर्डर कर लीजिएगा। आई विल टेक योर क्वेश्चन आफ्टर आई फिनिश, ओके। यू वॉन्ट इंग्लिश, ओके। सो फॉलो क्रॉनिकल आईएएस, बाय क्रॉनिकल आईएएस आइदर फ्रॉम मार्केट, आई गेस इन मार्केट इट्स नॉट अवेलेबल राइट नाउ, सो ऑर्डर इट फ्रॉम ऑनलाइन, मे बी amazon.in, बाय इट, इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बुक, सॉल्व्ड आंसर क्वेश्चन आंसर्स 2016, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8 और भी बहुत पुराने मच ओल्डर क्वेश्चंस आल्सो with answers, with model answers. It's a gem, this book. Whatever would be left in your study material or preparation would be covered through these past year questions and answers. Okay? Because in history, 40 to 50% of the paper in some form or the other would come from past 10-15 years questions. It is a static subject, it's not dynamic. What Akbar did would be asked again. What Akbar's Rajput policy was, 10 saal pehle agar puchenge, aaj bhi puchenge, okay? Ashoka's Dhamma policy, it has remained same. Okay, there are not much discoveries, little discoveries of Aryan invasion theory, etc., which can be updated via newspapers, but not much. Don't go for current affairs in history through this. What this new seal has been found or this has been found. Don't stress out yourself after these things. It will not come. Neither you need to use it as a reference even in your answers. You don't need to. Okay? You just have to do these book lists. You just have to complete Rao's IAS study material and chronicle IAS's past year question papers. That's it. How to do question papers? When you finish all these study material, now you are well versed with the ancient, medieval, modern world. Now take out one question paper, maybe modern India. Set a time limit in the morning, 9 to 10:30, at home or in library or whatever place. Do questions by your own self. Do questions on your own. Within a time frame, and then see what are the model answers. Rectify it, check it, have value addition, value enrichment in your answers. You would improve that way. One, your writing speed would improve, your own creativity would bloom because you will write answers on your own based on your understanding. Then you will enrich your content. You'll have more value addition and more value enrichment in your answers, in the subsequent answers or in the subsequent tests that you'll give. Okay? After that, join a test series. Give at least 10 to 12 tests. And get that evaluated. Have meticulous understanding of that evaluation and feedback given by teacher in that answer copy. And improve upon it next test. Work upon that and improve upon in next test. And probably they'll also give a model answer copy along with the tests. learn that test, learn that model answer copy the same day, the day you would give a test. Learn that for value addition, value enrichment, etc. Okay? And once you do these things, I'm very sure that you would be able to score a very decent marks or good marks even in history. I scored this time, I scored in my first attempt 262 out of 500. In my second attempt, I scored 290 out of 500, which was decent enough. In history, scoring around 300 is very good. Okay? There is nothing much to say, speak in history, apart from the book list that I have given. Just follow ma'am's teaching methods, teaching modules. And if you have any sort of questions, please do ask.
Hello sir, warm greetings. Sir, I wanted to ask, when we write the answer, when we begin writing the answer, so how to shorten it? So we have, like, we're writing the geographical aspect of history. So there are so many things to write and we have to concise the answer in 200 words. So I am not able to, you know, concise it because there are a lot of things to write and I'm not able to segregate what to miss out and what not to. So basically this is the answer.
It will come though with practice. Initially you would face a problem. You're just 1 month old in coaching. It is fine if you have a lot of content. As time passes on, you'd automatically shorten up and you'll automatically know what is important, what is relevant and what is not important. Probably if you are saying there are geographical factors, then just instill one or two examples to substantiate it. You don't need to go any further. Let me give you an example. This time in mains, there was one question on evolution of temple architecture in India. Evolution of temple architecture in India and regional variations of temples in India. I wrote a very good answer of 3 pages. I thought it's a good answer. I wrote about Kashmir ka temple architecture, Tamil Nadu ka temple architecture, Eastern India ka temple architecture, Western India's temple architecture, Central India Khajuraho temples and other temple architecture and evolution, Buddhist stupas and what not. And the candidate sitting at the back, when the paper got finished, he told me, did you write about this temple? I said, no, I did not write about this temple. He said, oh. I said, did you write about this temple, this particular temple? He said, no. And I was like, okay, balanced. So, do you understand? Don't have this feeling of missing out. You just need to fill those 3 pages qualitatively. If you are saying one factor is geographical factor, and then just substantiate it with any one example, even if you know 10 examples, it would not matter. If you would write only one example, that would in itself be sufficient for the examiner to understand that you know. Okay?
Yes.
You don't need to stress out yourself after ki nahi yaar maine ye wala example chhod diya aur ye wala content chhod diya. Okay? The factor should be very crisp, like geographical factors, political factors, social factors, and one substantiation. One or two substantiations. Do you understand what I say?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Fine, sir.
Good morning, sir. The syllabus is so vast. How do you revise before the examination? Like, is there, like, you make even shorter notes of your already, like, class notes and all? Or do you have, some order in which you revise some?
In history, in optionals particularly, I would say comprehensive notes are important. I personally never made notes, but I scribbled a lot. Scribbled, do you understand what is scribbling? Rough copies, like this, which cannot be revised. Very dirty, very scribbled, very dirty notes. But I kept on scribbling like this. Okay, do you understand? Scribbled, lots of scribbling, so that it becomes a part of me. It no more is a note, I remember it. Okay, so much of scribbling, so much of continuous rough working. Even when you read a newspaper, okay, scribble. If there is an article on inclusive growth, inclusive development, the article would cover only one or two aspects about inclusive growth. that particular article, kyunki wo particular article UPSC ke liye thodi likha hua hai, so that would cover every sub, every aspect or multidimensional aspect of inclusive growth. It would not. So, but there and then, think inclusive growth or inclusive development is a topic in syllabus. So what all I do, I know about inclusive growth, I'll start writing there. Challenges to inclusive growth, one, on newspaper itself, two, three, four, five, okay. What can be done to further, what has been done, what are the schemes which were done to improve inclusive growth in India. So I'll write down the schemes, what I know. So I'm broadening that article. I'm not just being restricted to that article, how to read a newspaper. Okay, what are the measures, what can be done further to have more inclusive growth. So I'll write it down there itself. So in a way I'm daily preparing for mains while reading a newspaper. That's the best way to read a newspaper. Okay, to scribble a lot even on that editorial page. Okay, similar goes with my strategy. Anybody's strategy would be different, other strategy would be different. Comprehensive notes are also advisable if someone's acumen is like that, but I personally scribbled a lot so that my creativity does not get constricted, because the test in UPSC at the end in mains is a test of creativity. But still I would tell you how to approach essay paper. Yeah. This time I wrote on farmers' unsustainability. You might have gone through the papers. Please go through papers. Please go through this year's mains papers, history ka optional papers, GS ka papers, and prelims papers of 2017, 16, 15, 14, 13. That's it. Both mains as well as prelims. Optional ke liye, you can go further back, 2012, 11, 10, 9, 8. But for GS, have an understanding of what are the nature of questions that come in prelims and mains, GS, 2013 onwards. Okay, what are the nature of questions being asked in essay? Okay, if you read current affairs, GS, history optional, you'd have a lot of content by the end of 1 year and you'd be able to write a very good essay. You just, at that time, you just need to process your content to the demand of the essay. Okay, that would be done later on when you will join a test series in essay. Okay. You'll already have a lot of knowledge because of GS, because of history optional. You can probably use your knowledge in GS and history in your essay. Okay, for example, there was an essay this time, farmers, majority of farmers, farming has become an unsustainable job in India for majority of small and marginal farmers. So I wrote down, I started with a historical perspective. That Makar Sankranti, Pongal, these all Bihu depict the agricultural samriddhshali jo hota hai agriculture, usko depict karta hai ye. And somewhere we lost, not right now, but during the colonialism period, there was Riotwari settlement, Mahalwari and Zamindari settlement. Land reforms were half-hearted post-independence also. So it's not anything new that farming has become unsustainable. It has been from a very long time. Now it has worsened off due to ecological factors, economical factors. MSP is not given. Ecological factors, maybe drought, global warming, floods. There is no crop insurance. Okay, then you can branch out further. Watch my Vovala video on YouTube and probably other videos on essay of toppers on YouTube. You can probably get a better clarity on that. Okay. Multidimensional is the approach in essay. You have to include all political factors, international factors. How international factor can be included in farming has become unsustainable. Because of liberalization, our products have become uncompetitive in the global market. Okay. This way you have to, political factor. What is the political factor? Loan waivers. So there is, it's a political game to have vote bank policy, etc. So political loan waivers is one aspect which is unsustainable solution to unsustainable farming. It's not a long term sustainable feature or a solution. And then you'll have to give a way forward or a conclusion in a very good manner. way forward you can give probably the various schemes of government like Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana or organic farming, Sikkim has become organic state. Then you can probably say universal crop insurance scheme, Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Okay, so things are being done. Contract farming, model APMC Act. With better reading in GS, you will probably understand how to write an essay. Okay, thank you very much.